Russian Grandmaster Daniil Yuffa joins us in our studio with an impressive win with the black pieces. Daniil, 2 out of 2, a good start. Pleased with the result, but also the quality of the games?
Frankly speaking, I'm quite pleased with the result because last year I just managed to score 1.5 after 2 rounds, but now I started 2 out of 2 and I'm expecting a very interesting game tomorrow, probably against one of the top seeds.
It's also important in these open tournaments to start well so that you're able to play these top seeds in the middle.
Well, the main thing is just to score full points against the lower rated players, and personally my main goal is just to show good quality chess.
And with the black pieces, when you have that sort of an aim to try and win every game, what's the approach when you're playing somebody who's lower rated than you? Because today you complicated it quite quickly.
Yeah, but I'm not an expert with playing with black pieces. I have much worse statistics playing with black instead of playing with white. But today I was lucky that because maybe I've received the position I've been dreaming about, like after move 12, because after Queen d3, so maybe bishop e3, king h1. I've been preparing for this very popular lines in either bishop e6, bishop d2, knight d7, knight d5. So it's more or less, I think, yeah, I can't say that's a well-known position, but it's like several games been played there. I took on d5, and what do I mean when I say that I had received the dream position? So I have my favorite king's Indian structure. And, well, usually when I have this kind of structure, I'm quite satisfied about the opening. Yeah, so c4 and then a5.
So knight off that converted into a King's Indian structure.
Yeah, so I was very pleased with the results of the opening. And so rook ac1 and probably, yeah, c1 is not the best spot for the rook because, like, the main point that after a4, knight a1, well, the knight is situated a bit. Strangely, yeah, it's awkward place for knight. Knight c5, queen h3, knight e4. And the point that I'm trading the black's color bishops and white's pair of bishops just wastes.
So like, you just want to go bishop g5 next and get rid of your bad piece.
That's what I did. Knight c2, I took on e3, queen e3. Also, white lost a lot of tempos playing like queen h3, queen e3 back. Knight a3, f4, and I have just a crushing attack, probably just permanently winning position.
It looks like you got everything, and white really didn't create any chances at all here.
Yeah, so once again, I don't want to repeat myself, but I received like an improved King's Indian defense. I have a crushing attack, I have very nice pair of knights blocking. Blocking knight on c5, knight on e4 is quite good.
Yes.
And, like, obviously this piece has to be improved, like, quite. I mean, instantly, knight b5, rook f6, queen e3. The one very small and cute thing that if, like, let's say queen h4, preventing, like, rook h6 ideas, I think I've calculated something, like, f3, the point that if bishop takes and I play knight d2, and then, like, knight f3 and rook g6 is the threat. Yeah, but the position is winning, and after rook g6, rook c2, I play queen h4. And the point, first of all, I didn't see, I mean, I realized that my position is winning, but I didn't see the solution. And after b4, knight b3 came, and so.
This is a really beautiful move, actually. So what was after ab3? You're just...
Yeah, I'm playing queen h3.
So you cut off the queen from the third rank.
I think I've saw one of this idea. Yeah, in a lot of games, I think Hikaru Nakamura had something similar in King's Indian. And the point that after knight b3, let's say if white is trying to protect the second rank, like playing f3, still, I mean, there is no chance to escape because, like, now I'm cutting off the rook, so it's a funny position, like queen is cut it off and rook is cut it off, and white, black is simply winning.
These two knights, first on c5, e4, and then on b3, d2, really make white's life very difficult.
Yeah, that's
but this is quite interesting that after queen h3, actually there's just no way to defend against the mate.
Yeah, let's bishop e3, I take the bishop, so g3, then rook h6, and there is no defense, unfortunately, for white. And after knight b3, I was a bit inaccurate because, like, after bishop e3, I played knight d2, but that was an inaccuracy. Yeah, because, I mean, I allowed rook takes d2, knight d2, like rook d1. Obviously, I take on c4, play rook c8, the position is winning. But instead of playing knight e d2, maybe knight g5 was more accurate and, yeah, more precise.
Oh, and in fact, he resigned on knight d2. But
yeah, I had 35 minutes against 30 seconds, 13 more moves. Yeah, I can take on c4 and play rook c8, I think. At least I can take on f3.
It looks really bad for white anyway. Well, a really nice aggressive attacking game, and I'm sure that's a good warm-up for the rounds to come. And the other thing that you've been doing for warming up has been playing a little bit of piano in the hotel bar.
Yeah, that's true. I used to play piano for a long period of time in my life. I finished the musical school, but like last couple of years, I didn't have a lot of practice. So I hope it wasn't that weird. And usually when I play piano during the tournaments, it somehow helped me to feel some kind of confidence. And I'm trying to play as artificial as I'm playing the piano. I mean, I'm trying to create these kind of games, like maybe, well, I can't say that this game was like 100% artificial, but still I was inspired and play other, a normal attacking game.
Well, that's some very creative and inspired chess over the board, like you said. We look forward to having you more at the piano, but also more at chess.
Yeah, me too.
And thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.